Now, this is no ordinary USB-C port, because when we look at its back, then we can see some tiny circuitry here, since this is supposedly one of the tiniest battery chargers out there. And of course, I found this crazy product on AliExpress, which is a Chinese online store where you can find the newest, weirdest, and sometimes super useful products. But since the product descriptions there are always pretty vague and you can't really trust most of the reviews, you never really know whether a product is truly a hidden gem or simply garbage. And that is why I created this video series. And today I got 7 intriguing looking products to check out, in order to ultimately tell you whether you should check them out as well or stay away from them. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by boot.dev, probably the most fun way to learn coding. Now, as you might know, I can do some rudimentary C programming for my Arduino projects, but I'm definitely no expert. So I was very happy when I recently found out that boot.dev does exist, where you can learn Python, Linux, Git, and tons more, which all ties into backend programming. The lessons start simple, but it gets challenging quickly. However, you can always ask for help, and as you probably already noticed, this is like an RPG, where you get experience points, achievements, you can buy stuff from a shop, and so on. It's totally my kind of game, and if it sounds like your game as well, then you can read and demo a lot of it for free. And if you want to commit and become a member, then you can use my coupon code here or the link in the video description to get 25% off your entire first year. Now let's get started with a problem that I always encounter during summertime. You see, blowing up paddling pools or similar with a hand pump just kind of sucks. And that is why I got myself this electric air pump from AliExpress, which you nowadays can get for 54 euro. But a while back, I got mine for quite a bit cheaper. And according to its description, it should be able to do the tasks I have in mind for it. So after unpacking, I was not only greeted with the main pump, but also different nozzle sizes, as well as a carrying bag. What I immediately loved was the small size of this thing, which makes it ideal for camping. I also liked the additional super bright LED lights, as well as the rather nice overall quality. But of course, what was most important to me was the pump function, which was kind of weird to activate though by double tapping. But the good news is that the created airflow seems rather powerful and promising. So time for a real life test with the mini pool, by adding the fitting nozzle and letting it do its thing, which worked out perfectly. And all in all, it took a total of 41 seconds, which is a big step up to the hand pump, that required 3 minutes and 18 seconds. And needless to say, the deflation feature also worked beautifully, and is quite useful, I would say, to store the pool more easily. But now let's move over to the hardcore testing, because this product flexes with its 5 kilopascal pressure, its 500 liter per minute airflow, and its runtime, which I all need to confirm. I did that by utilizing a pressure sensor with an Arduino, by measuring its created wind speed, and by taking this thing apart and having a look at its batteries and current draw. By the way, I was very happy with the quality of the circuit boards, wiring, and so on inside this thing. And after doing all my testing, it seems like most promised features are true. Except the airflow, which was noticeably less in my measurements. But besides that, I really like this product, and I think it is a must-have if you have to pump up lots of stuff. And with that being said, let's move on to this weird-looking circuit board, which is a super new 20-meter LiDAR module that you can get for around 15 euro. In case you don't know, such LiDAR modules send out a laser beam and notice its return, and by calculating with the speed of light, it can calculate the distance to the object it hits. So it's basically a distance sensor, but let's be honest, such LiDAR sensors are not rare anymore. And it also not rotates like this one, and thus lets you scan the entire environment around it. So why should I care about this one? Well, in comparison to others, it handles sunlight resistance pretty well, and it comes with a great detection range and frame rate, all at a super low price point. The only big negative I immediately noticed was that there's not much information available about this thing. But thankfully, someone already created an Arduino library, meaning I followed the given wiring scheme to hook up the LiDAR to an ESP32 and then uploaded the given example sketch, which sadly did not work no matter what I tried. And since I suck at programming, I simply uploaded the Chinese datasheet to ChatGPT and asked for an Arduino sketch, which, believe it or not, actually worked on the first try. So next I firstly did some testing inside, which worked out beautifully, and then went outside in direct sunlight. And to my own surprise, this thing delivered accurate values up to a distance of around 13 meters. Amazing! So yeah, if you're looking for cheap and precise distance measurement, then this thing might be what you're looking for. And that brings us to the third products, which are actually two. I included those because I have similar ones laying around that are awesome, but I rarely use them. One of them is a turbofan, which, as you would expect, creates a powerful airflow and thus can be used to clean up. And the other one is a portable soldering iron, which, you know, can solder stuff. And the problem I have with these is that they require a custom lithium battery pack for power, and I do not always have them in reach. But what I do have in reach are my Makita battery packs that I usually use for my power tools. And you guessed it, this new turbofan and portable soldering iron do support Makita batteries, and their price point is also pretty good, I would say. And of course, other battery brands are also supported. So I did some testing with both products, and they both do their job just fine, even though I feel like the quality of the turbofan is a bit lacking. But what most people probably care about is the runtime with one battery, and when using a 5 Ah one like I do, then we can expect around 45 minutes with the fan and around 3.3 hours with the soldering iron, which is pretty good, I would say. And after taking these products apart, they also seem to be made good enough. And once again, only the fan stands out a bit by promising some too good to be true values. But even with that in mind, I would still give both products the thumbs up. Next, we surely got a fascinating looking product, which is a so-called Rodin coil that you can get for around 52 euro. Quite expensive for a bit of copper. Now, truth be told, I ordered this because of its looks before having a look at the product description. Otherwise, I would have probably avoided this so-called free energy device. But besides that, the product description does not give us a lot of information. So I did some research on my own and found out that the name comes from Marco Rodin, who created this special geometry for the coil windings. Now, normally when creating a coil, you simply wind the wire around something multiple times, and then you end up with something like this. To create energy, you would then spin a magnet inside or near this thing to induce a voltage. With the Rodin coil, it should be a similar story. However, due to its geometry, it is claimed that the induced voltage is a bit different in strength, and should even go to zero in the middle. And yes, it was quite interesting to see how different regions altered the strength of the induced voltage, meaning for a science experiment, this is certainly interesting. However, due to the big price point for what it is and the promotion of free energy, I still have to give it the thumbs down. And that finally brings us to this tiny USB-C battery charger that you can get for super cheap. But I think here the shipping costs are part of the price. Now when looking at the main IC, then we can read LP4054, which is a 600mAh lithium-ion charger IC, meaning we can basically charge up any 4.2V lithium battery. So let's try it out with this rather small one right here. What I immediately noticed though was that the plus solder pad is pretty close to ground, meaning we could cause a battery short if we are not careful. Thankfully though, that did not happen. And thus, after powering this all with a USB-C cable, we enter constant current mode, in which the battery gets charged up with 600mA. While doing that, the IC got pretty hot, because it is a linear charger. But don't worry, it comes with thermal regulation, meaning nothing will blow up. I mean, we could lower the current and thus heat by changing one resistor, but these sizes are a bit too small for me. But anyway, eventually the charger entered constant voltage mode, and ultimately charged up the battery just fine to 4.2V, meaning it does its job perfectly fine. And thus, if you're looking for a tiny battery charger, I would certainly recommend this board. And that brings us to the last product for today, which is this anti-loss tracking card that you can get for around 16 €. As the name and product description suggests, you can find this thing not only in your home near you, but you can also find it everywhere in the world when it gets lost. That sounds pretty sweet, and after having a look at its manual, it should be pretty self-explanatory. You basically turn it on via a button push, and then it automatically pairs with your phone, and in just a few seconds, everything is set up. The first thing you can do now is play a sound on it, which can be really useful if you misplaced your wallet or similar. I did some testing, and this feature truly worked no matter where I was in my home. And the next feature is of course great when you lose your wallet, because then you should be able to track this thing. But wait a minute, how does it do that without a SIM card or GPS? Well, it apparently sends out Bluetooth low energy signals, and if someone is close by with a phone and a service, then we use the phone's GPS to tell the owner of the card where it is located. And yes, that really worked for me. So last for testing, I cut this thing open to find some pretty good looking insides. And in case you're wondering, you can charge this thing up wirelessly. And to find out how long the battery will last, I simply hooked up my low power analyzer. It seems like it needs around 24 microamps on average, meaning the battery should last around 5 to 6 months, which is pretty much what they promise. The only thing I don't like is that you have to register on another app to use this if found scan QR code feature. But besides that, this card can be a real lifesaver, and thus I give it the thumbs up. And just like that, we covered some more intriguing products. And this time there was way more positive than negative stuff, which I'm quite happy about. And don't worry, like always, there's plenty more to explore, so stay tuned for the next episode. Until then, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!